We're here in Churchill, Manitoba, adjacent to Wapus National Park, because this is one of the few places in the Arctic that polar bears congregate every year. All of the polar bears in this subpopulation come to shore every summer, and most of them are stretched out along the shore near where we are today.
One of the challenges of polar bear conservation is to keep people and polar bears safe. We have families up here in the Arctic and here in Churchill that live with polar bears every day. Trying to find ways to keep polar bears and humans away from each other, find solutions that are best for both, is something that we're working towards.
Northern communities have lived with polar bears for hundreds of years in some cases. Here in Churchill, this is what we'd call a more modern community, and they have a more modern approach to how they safely interact and deal with polar bears. They hire professional conservation officers who come to town. Some are here year-round, some are added during polar bear season, and they're physically patrolling the perimeter of town and in town looking to intercept polar bears that come in and to move those bears or haze them along. The only downside of that approach is darkness and poor weather. Snow and blowing snow limit our abilities to detect them, because right now we're relying on people seeing them and residents reporting those bears, and that's true across most of the Arctic. This year, in partnership with the Hogel Zoo, Polar Bears International is able to pilot a new project using some of the latest technology available. It's called Compact Surveillance Radar. We're going to deploy this radar here in Churchill and try to overcome that one weak spot of traditional polar bear guarding or polar bear monitoring, and that's our eyes, our eyesight. We can't see very well at night, and we definitely can't see through snow where the radar can. So we'll be positioning this radar on the backside of Churchill. We'll be testing its ability to detect polar bears, and we hope in the following 2 years of the project to look at the ability of this equipment to possibly deter polar bears remotely.
Compact surveillance radar is perfect for conditions just like this. We have low visibility right now, and we are right on the shores of Hudson Bay during the polar bear migration here in Churchill, Manitoba. The compact surveillance radar can detect targets coming into the community like polar bears before they get into town, and it can alert management authorities before the animals get here so they can deal with them before anybody gets hurt. We have the CSR, or compact surveillance radar, mounted to the complex here in Churchill, Manitoba. It's a building that houses the school, it houses the swimming pool, the hospital, and we thought it would be a perfect place to test this tool here.
Across the Arctic, we're seeing more polar bears spend longer periods of time on shore. Why are they doing that? Because there's less sea ice. There's less sea ice because we're burning too much fossil fuel, it's warming our atmosphere, and it's melting that ice. So we're trying to get ahead of the curve with polar bears and to make sure communities, people who work in the Arctic, people who play in the Arctic, have the tools and technology they need to keep themselves and polar bears safe.
Unlike Churchill, who has a great polar bear alert program, communities north of here don't have such systems in place. So the radar system will hopefully detect polar bears entering communities and not only keep polar bears safe, but also keep people in the community safe as well. Whether in Churchill, Manitoba, or other places in the Arctic, we have to be working collaboratively. That means working with universities, other NGOs, zoos and aquariums, and other conservation-oriented groups to come together and work on behalf of that wildlife that you're trying to conserve.